I've interacted with TI quite a number of times, and I've seen the passion with which TI actually was doing research in education and was trying to reach out to children and was trying to also supplement the efforts of the government, which actually I think is very welcome, and I would love to thank TI for the wonderful work that they have been doing in the field of education. Well, just going into education in India, we all know for a fact that we are at very interesting times in India today, where we are looking at reforms, trying to bring in greater focus on education and trying to see how we can actually improve the education system in our country. And of course, reforms is an ongoing process. It doesn't begin with one day and end at one day, but this is an ongoing process. And we know for a fact that before India attained independence, there was an education system in our country which probably we felt was to serve a very limited purpose, to serve the interests of the colonial rulers. And after we attained independence, there was this necessity to actually usher in an education system that would actually support our own interests, our own needs and our own requirements. And it was then that the University Education Commission was constituted under the chairmanship of Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. And submitting its recommendations, the University Education Commission had emphasized that education does not have any relevance if it did not relate to modernity. Of course, this is only one recommendation that was given by the University Education Commission along with a slew of other recommendations. But we definitely feel that this recommendation has great importance and need to be taken very seriously, because when we talk of education relating to modernity, it speaks of changing times, it speaks of changing scenarios, it also speaks of new challenges and issues that countries face. And today, for a fact, we know that education is no longer a goal, but it is rather a powerful driver of socio-economic change. And therefore, we need to introspect, look into our own education system and see if it is really responding to the challenges that our country actually faces today. And it is a fact that education is actually considered one of the most important factors for any country's development and growth. The World Economic Forum as well had laid down 9 parameters to assess the competitiveness of countries, or rather economies, and 5 out of the 9 parameters that have been laid down by the World Economic Forum actually relate to the quality and quantity of education in those particular economies. Therefore, it is an indisputed fact that education needs to be given utmost priority, more particular in the developing nations, and more particularly in India, where it has been rightly pointed out by Dr. Peter Belita, where we have a large workforce which needs to be streamlined, which needs to be grew.